It's time for The Splash Live from Civic Center TV, featuring stories from and about people like you in the greater West Bloomfield area. Simulcast on cable, 89.3 Lakes FM, social media, and the web. Now live from Green Media Center on Walnut Lake Road, it's The Splash Live.
Live, local, social, it's The Splash Live. I'm Tyler Kieft, and thank you for joining us as you can each and every day on all of our different outlets across all different media. You can find us on cable television every day on Comcast, Channel 15, and on AT&T, Channel 99. Find us on the web, best place to go to watch us, arguably, of any of our outlets, high definition, live, and on demand on civiccentertv.com. That's also where you'll find links to our social media, where today, as always, you can find us live on Facebook at Civic Center TV 15 and on YouTube at Civic Center TV. In addition, we're always with you on the radio across all four of our communities, live and on demand every day, live and all throughout the day on 89.3 Lakes FM, a 24-hour a day, 7-day a week live simulcast of Civic Center TV programming. So we're with you in your home and on the road every single day. Looking at our weather report, after a snowy Tuesday, a little bit calmer as we go into the next few days. Today, Wednesday, high of 39, low of 31. Going to be cloudy, some light winds, but a little bit of sunshine peering through those clouds periodically throughout the day. Mostly cloudy to cloudy on this Wednesday. Thursday, a bit of a warm-up, high of 42 and a low of 32. Partly cloudy during the morning, then mostly cloudy the remainder of the day. And finally, on Friday, high of 36, low of 29. Some sunlight peering through those clouds later on in the day with a partly cloudy night to go along with it. Plenty making headlines across the greater West Bloomfield community. We talk about the snowy weather we had on Tuesday. It's time to take a look throughout our community. And as you're plowing your driveway, as you're looking at the roads in your community being shoveled or being plowed in recent days, keep in mind our fire hydrants. We'll have some helpful advice from the West Bloomfield Fire Department on what to do to make sure you're clearing the way for safety in the case of an emergency across our community. There's a chance also to join a local Girl Scout troop in the greater West Bloomfield area over at Roosevelt Elementary School. We'll tell you about how you can join in on that troop in a special meeting tonight. We'll check in with head coach Darrin McAllister from the West Bloomfield Girls Basketball Team, off to a very hot start, including a big matchup last night against another undefeated OAA Red Division team. We'll talk to him about another surging season for the girls on the basketball court. It's almost time for West Bloomfield Educational Foundation's Casino Night fundraiser later on this week. We'll give you the where, the when, how you can still get tickets, and then we'll even talk about one way that funding from the WBEF is already impacting a classroom and a set of classrooms right here in our school district. Taste of Keego 2.0 is underway in the city of Keego Harbor now through the end of this coming weekend. We'll tell you about some restaurants that are involved in that and some of the deals you can get out and about as you're eating in Keego Harbor this week. We continue to celebrate 50 years of the Greater West Bloomfield Historical Society in our community. We were at their recent event commemorating their 50th anniversary and their annual meeting. And we got some special announcements about when that full program will begin airing here on Civic Center TV that we'll tell you about later on in the program. Art Sale is seeking artists for an upcoming show at the Oakland County Farmers Market later on in the year, but they're seeking those artists now. So we'll tell you about this collective, how you can join in on the fun, and how you can get maybe your art on display at the Oakland County Farmers Market later on this year. We'll talk about protecting our local wildlife and a chance for you and your family to learn more about nature with Lauren Missouri from West Bloomfield Parks. In addition, we'll even tell you how you can celebrate some of our volunteers in our community at this year's Michigan Week Community Awards breakfast. All of that and more coming up. We are live, local, and social each and every day on The Splash Live. Stay with us. We'll be right back on Civic Center TV and 89.3 Lakes FM.
We'll be right back with The Splash Live. This is Civic Center TV and 89.3 Lakes FM. On cable and the radio. On the web too, and on social media. Civic Center TV, television that's close to home. Take a break and tune in to The Splash Live on Civic Center TV and 89.3 Lakes FM. Join Tyler Kieft as he goes through headlines and events, updating you on the day-to-day happenings in Oakland County. Catch us live weekdays 8:30 a.m. to 12:30 p.m. Watch us on demand at civiccentertv.com. Or watch us on TV at Comcast Channel 15 or AT&T at Channel 99.
When you have a gambling problem, you have a money problem. Don't let your gambling cause you financial hardship. If you or someone you love is struggling with gambling, we can help. Get free confidential counseling and win your life back. Learn more at michigan.gov/problemgambling.
I'm an ex-drug dealer, and I'll be your sub today. Two milligrams of fentanyl can be lethal. A lethal dose is in here. Who gets it, I won't know.
It's cheap, it's potent, and it's profitable.
The sad reality is fentanyl is being mixed into everything now.
More kitchen now.
Missed one of our live broadcasts or one of your local municipal meetings? Check it out online at civiccentertv.com. Every meeting, show, and interview on demand. Thank you for watching and listening to Civic Center TV and 89.3 Lakes FM. And now, back to The Splash, live.
Live, local, social, it's The Splash Live on Civic Center TV and 89.3 Lakes FM. I'm Tyler Kieft. Welcome back to the program. Of course, we had some recent snow come back onto the ground throughout the greater West Bloomfield area after a snowy day on Tuesday. And it's a good reminder now from the West Bloomfield Fire Department as you're clearing your driveways and nearby sidewalks, and especially if plowing services for your neighborhood have gone through your local roadways, to keep in mind fire safety during this winter season. Our fire hydrants need clearance for our fire department from West Bloomfield and in the Tri-Cities to respond to emergencies expediently in our community. Every second counts, and if the fire hydrant is blocked, they can't get to those fire hydrants, so they have to clear them out before they can tend to putting out a fire at your home or at your business. West Bloomfield Fire Department recently posting this image, this infographic, on their Facebook page at WB Fire Department, encouraging you to keep them clear at least 3 feet all around our nearby fire hydrants is what they need in order to get their hoses connected safely and efficiently and start putting out fires in your home or your business. Again, every second counts as they try to fight these fires. And now that could be the difference between a building staying up and just needing some repairs or burning all the way to the point where it's totaled. And also could be a huge safety concern for you, for your family, for your pets, for your heirlooms and your belongings in your home or in your business. So this is really good advice. And you can always find more advice on winter weather emergencies and prevention tips for fires in your home, in your business, and throughout the community by visiting their Facebook page at WB Fire Department. Really good advice from the West Bloomfield Fire Department. And want to encourage you to go to our on-demand page as well. We had a great conversation earlier this week with Fire Marshal Byron Turnquist about some additional ways you can prepare in case you are a victim of a fire, what you need to protect, and how you can go about doing that. Some really good advice. A local Girl Scout troop is looking for some new members in the heart of the Lakes. Roosevelt Elementary School's local Girl Scouts troop is holding an informational meeting tonight in the I Center at Roosevelt School. It'll be happening at 6:30 p.m. You can join in on the informational meeting for free. Again, it's a family informational meeting. Come on by, meet the troop leaders, meet other members of the troop that are either returning or maybe interested. Get to know some families in the community, make some new friends, and learn about some new experiences as well. Not only do they go on fun trips and work on different projects, they learn community service, they learn some business and marketing and of course mathematics skills when they're selling their cookies throughout the year and during cookie season, and so much more. So if you want to get involved, on your screen right now on civiccentertv.com is their flyer. There's a QR code there you can scan for even more information and to sign up if you're already interested in joining this troop. Or there's other ways to get in contact with them. Contact Mary Beth Mills at the email that's on your screen, mmills@gssem.org. That's MMILLS at gssem.org, or you can even call her at 248-871-9201. Again, that phone number, if you are interested and want to call Mary Beth Mills and the team at the Girl Scouts of Southeastern Michigan, 248-871-9201. Our girls and our Girl Scout troop doing great things all throughout the community, and that's also the case for our girls on the basketball court. We're going to take a break on the Splash Live. On the other side, the best ball in town is at West Bloomfield High School, and it's the girls basketball team once again dominant as they start their 2023-2024 campaign. Their head coach, Darrin McAllister, will be live, local, social with us here at the Splash Live next on Civic Center TV and 89.3 Lakes FM.
We'll be right back with the Splash Live. Bringing you stories and memories from Keego Harbor, Civic Center TV, and 89.3 Lakes FM.
A fresh start lets you refocus, helping you live in the moment. Where you can take the lead or take a bow, basking in the glitz and the glow of winter. Because when the snow begins to fall, you feel the excitement rise. Set your sights on a winter wonderland as Fresh finds new ways forward in Pure Michigan.
When I was in foster care, I never knew when I would have to move. So I always had my suitcase ready to go. Then one day, I was adopted. My new parents opened their hearts and home to me. My parents cook my favorite breakfast for me every morning. My parents take me on trips I never thought I would go on. They gave me a home and an even better reason to use that suitcase. My parents aren't perfect, but they're perfect for me.
Want to enjoy Civic Center TV on your social media? Find us on Instagram at Civic Center TV. Get notified when we upload one of our interviews, full episodes, and more. Thank you for watching and listening to Civic Center TV and 89.3 Lakes FM. And now, back to the Splash, live.
Live, local, social, it's the Splash Live each and every day on Civic Center TV and 89.3 Lakes FM. I'm your host, Tyler Keith, and encourage you to always stay up to date with us and find all of our links to our social media on our website, civiccentertv.com. Once again, in 2023 and 2024, the West Bloomfield Lakers girls varsity basketball team is among the top in the state and those ranked amongst girls basketball teams across the nation at the high school level. Over the last three games, these Laker girls have scored 65 points on average, and their opponents just 18 points on average per game. That's just a little bit of what they're doing have done so far on their way to a 12-0 start to this season. Joining us on the program now is their head coach, Darrin McAllister. Once again, Darrin, thank you for being with us on the Splash Live.
Good morning, Tyler. How are you?
I'm doing great. And how are you coming off of a win last night on the road at Stony Creek?
Feels pretty good. We're ready to get back in the gym and get some work.
Yeah, it's a tough season for the Lakers. It's a tough season for everyone. It's a long season that begins in mid-December, runs all the way through the end of February, and that's before you even get into playoff time. But once again, your team is off to a strong start. 12 consecutive wins to start the season. They're scoring a ton of points, but they're also really limiting the scoring from the other teams. But there's always a different identity one season to the next. What so far have you noticed is this current team's identity?
Well, each year we come up with a mantra and then we identify who we are, the team. Our first year there, we had the identity of I believe. And the second year, we had the identity of together. And this year, we have the identity of we will. And that all starts with a mindset, believing that we can accomplish or overcome anything that comes in front of us. We've been successful so far, being undefeated. But at the end of the day, wins and losses in the month of December, January, and February means nothing. You're playing for the month of March.
And so that comes back to the focal points of this team. You've built this team quite strategically over the years to fit the vision you've had for what a great girls basketball program can be at the high school level, and really what a great basketball program is, girls, boys, men's, women's, at any level, professional, high school, college, and so on. What are your focal points, particularly in this season, that this team's really so far bought into?
Just one word, defense. Defense, that's solely what it is. You know, a lot of people focus on the amount of points that we score a game, and we don't focus on that. That's not important to us. Our goal is to go out there and to stop people or slow them down, and everything else will take care of itself.
Yeah, anytime you're limiting a team to right around 20 points, less than 30 points at any level, whether it's throughout the entirety of a game or, you know, even on the professional side throughout a quarter, you're doing something right. And over these last five games, looking at these final scores, last night at Stony Creek, 60-19, 71-20, 66-15, 62-20, 74-27, going back to January 16th against Lake Orion, a team you're going to see again very soon. That's pretty daunting. You see those big scoring totals, but you also see the really small scoring totals for your opponents. Now, what is the key to adopting that defensive-first mindset for your team?
It all starts with just being unselfish and believing in each other and loving each other on and off the court. Our players, this is a great group of players. I'm really excited about this team this year. I've been excited about the teams before, but this team is special because I've had these group of girls for three seasons, and they bought into the mindset of defense. They bought into the mindset of believing and trusting the coaching staff, and we trust and believe in them. And so far, it's been working.
You've had a lot of really talented players on this team over your 3 years, a lot that have exited over the past 2 years. But as you said, the added benefit of that is you have that longevity of players that have been in this program throughout your tenure. They understand what you are trying to accomplish and what it takes to get to that championship level and even win a state championship. But what about these younger players that are coming up? How have they been acclimating, and how have they been, even beyond that, taking the leadership from the older players, the elder players on this team that are in their junior and senior years?
It's been phenomenal this year. It all starts with the leaders and the older players, not only telling the players what to do, but actually showing them what to do and leading by example. The younger players came in, and of course, they're starry-eyed, and they're looking at the older players and trying to find their way. But the great thing about it is most of the young players come in, and they have a sponge mentality, and they're absorbing all the information that they can. Even some of the transfers that came in, such as the Gamble Jones twins, they came in understanding, hey, we got to find our way on this team and identify our role. So it's been working so far. But the great part about it is this team is hungry, and they're continuing to work hard.
And you mentioned the hunger of this team. Coach McAllister, Darrin McAllister with us, head coach of the West Bloomfield Girls Varsity Basketball team. They are 12-0. They continue their campaign as they begin a four-game home streak on Friday at 7 o'clock at West Bloomfield High School against Rochester High School. You mentioned that hunger, and a lot of that, I would imagine, comes from the heartbreak at the end of last season, making it back to the state championship game, a chance to commit a rare feat in MHSAA basketball across all levels and going back to back, and came up just short against Rockford. How is that a tone setter, especially for upperclassmen coming into the season, and what has that brought to your team and its approach in this current season?
Well, you know, losing a game definitely was a heartbreaker. It was a learning experience and realizing that, you know, in certain areas that we could have worked better and executed better. But again, we had a young team last year. We only had two seniors, and one of them got the bulk of the playing time. So we were a young team. And as talented as we were and as much of success as we had last year, we still had a room for improvement and room to learn, and we did. And so with that loss, it actually put a chip on our shoulders, and the players have really worked hard during the offseason, and they carried over into the season. And I'm definitely seeing the fruits of their labor.
When you have a consistently good team and have built a consistently good program year in and year out, as you have in your 3 years with West Bloomfield, you know the talent's going to be there. You can kind of see how the execution of the game plan and what the coaching staff is preaching to these players is going to be there. But given that your team does have a bit of a youth movement to some extent this season, has there been any surprises for you, for your coaching staff, those that have players or different elements of your team that have stood out so far in 23 and 24?
Well, I think our coaching staff, you know, Jimmy Glenn's and Talisha Washington, has done a great job in developing our younger players. We have a couple younger players that stand out, such as Jordan Ratliff, who's contributing a lot on the varsity team. And then we have another sophomore, London Hall, who's doing double duty as far as playing JV and varsity. who has a bright, bright future with us. So that youth movement is awesome. It's fun to see. And I'm excited, obviously, about now, but I'm also excited about the future. But I will say this, Tyler, it all starts with our athletic director, Eric Pierce, giving us the resources that we need and all the tools that we need to be successful. So I definitely want to give a shout out to him and our coaching staff.
Yeah, the high school, the school district, very supportive of its athletic teams across the board, and have definitely put an investment into basketball, especially in recent years during the winter season. Shows on the court for the girls' teams, for the boys' teams, varsity, JV, freshmen, and all across the board. Joining us on the show today is the head coach of the West Bloomfield Girls Varsity Basketball team, Darrin McAllister. His Lakers are 12-0 heading into their next game coming up Friday night. A homestand begins at West Bloomfield High School against Rochester. Then there's four more games between then and February 13th when they take on Oxford for their final game of this four-game homestand. Coach, you're 12-0. You're coming off of previous 2 years, two straight appearances in the state championship game, one state championship, one runner-up appearance. There's always room for improvement, and knowing your coaching staff, knowing your team's approach, you're always looking to take that next step. At this point in the season, 12 games in, 12 wins in, playing excellent ball across the board, what are you looking for as that next step for your team to go from being a good team now to a great team, like you said, in March, where you really need to be playing your best basketball?
Well, at the end of the day, we just have to continue to do what we do. You know, I often tell the players, if you do what you're supposed to do, you're going to be who you're supposed to be. So if we continue to work hard and understand that every game we want to get better and realize that we're playing for March, we're putting money in the bank for March, because at the end of the day, what you do in December, January, and February means nothing. We're playing for March. So if we're doing what we're supposed to do in the month of March, I'm a happy coach.
You've developed this program over the past 3 years. You're developing this team over 3 months, getting toward the month of March. Coach, anything else that you'd like us to know or that we should be keeping in mind about this team as they continue through this 2024 campaign?
Well, I just definitely want to acknowledge some of the accomplishments of our seniors. You know, we have three McDonald's All-American nominees with Summer Davis, India Davis, and Kendall Hendricks. They've really worked hard and deserved that. And then we have Destin Washington, who I feel is a lot of times the underrated player in terms of getting the acknowledgement. She's definitely our floor general. She's our leader, and she's our best defender. And night in and night out, she gives up and sacrifices getting the points by going out there and defending the other team's best player. And then we have a sophomore that just stepped into the lineup and really has contributed, and that's Sheridan Beal. And she's been phenomenal. We butted heads a little bit during the early parts of the season, because when you have a talented player, they tend to think, hey, I haven't worked out. But then you have to realize, you know what, I have to realize that, you know, I don't know it all. And she's been phenomenal with that. So I just want to acknowledge this team and our reserve players are coming in and giving us bonus minutes as well. It's been fun this year. And, you know, we're not done. You know, so I would say, hey, get your popcorn ready.
Yeah, get your popcorn ready and get out to West Bloomfield High School. You're going to have plenty of opportunities in the coming weeks as they have a four-game homestand between Friday this week, February 2nd, and February 13th. All of those games at 7 o'clock at West Bloomfield High School. You can get more information on this team. Follow them on Twitter at WB State Champs, and you can also find more information on all of West Bloomfield High School athletics at westbloomfieldathletics.com. Coach McAllister, thank you so much for joining us.
Thank you, Tyler. Go Lakers, and we will.
Go Lakers, indeed. Their game on Friday against Rochester High School tips off at 7 o'clock p.m. And again, more information by following the West Bloomfield School District's athletic program on their website, westbloomfieldathletics.com. We'll take a break on the Splash Live. We'll continue to be live, local, and social on the other side with more stories from across our four communities and more conversations with people making headlines in the greater West Bloomfield area. The Splash Live returns next on Civic Center TV and 89.3 Lakes FM.
We'll be right back with the Splash Live. Bringing you stories and memories from Orchard Lake, Civic Center TV, and 89.3 Lakes FM.
When I was in foster care, I never knew when I would have to move, so I always had my suitcase ready to go. Then one day, I was adopted. My new parents opened their hearts and home to me. My parents cook my favorite breakfast for me every morning. My parents take me on trips I never thought I would go on. They gave me a home and an even better reason to use that suitcase. My parents aren't perfect, but they're perfect for me.
Take a break and tune in to the Splash Live on Civic Center TV and 89.3 Lakes FM. Join Tyler Kieft as he goes through headlines and events, updating you on the day-to-day happenings in Oakland County. Catch us live weekdays 8:30 a.m. to 12:30 p.m. Watch us on demand at civiccentertv.com. Or watch us on TV at Comcast Channel 15 or AT&T at Channel 99.
Ronnie started doing prescription pills at the age of 15. And by 19, he died. If your child is struggling with drug use, try not to be too proud to reach out for help. Don't be worried about what the neighbor will think or your family. Just get your child the help they need. Sometimes it's the hard road to take, but the hard road is nothing compared to living with the fact that your child is no longer with you.
There's hope and help at drugfree.org.
Find local municipal meetings at our program schedule on civiccentertv.com. Find when your meetings air live or when they're replaying on our Civic Center TV live stream. Find it all at civiccentertv.com and click schedule at the top of the screen. And now, back to the Splash, live.
Live, local, social, it's the Splash Live on Civic Center TV and 89.3 Lakes FM. I'm your host, Tyler Kieft. Thank you for tuning in across our whole network, including finding us live and on demand on civiccentertv.com. It is a great week in the city of Keego Harbor. It's always a great place to go for your favorite restaurants to get a good meal, breakfast, lunch, dinner, and anything in between. And this is particularly a good week with meals and deals all across the heart of the lakes. It's part of Taste of Keego 2.0, kicked off on Monday, concludes on Sunday, and all part of Keego Harbor Parks and Rec's effort to support our local businesses as they support Parks and Rec all throughout the year and other programs across the Keego Harbor community and beyond. One of those restaurants that is constantly in support of our local community and, of course, it has been a staple of Keego Harbor for decades is Gino's Pizzeria and Restaurant, one of the participating restaurants in Taste of Keego 2.0. And joining us now is one of their owners, Gino Santia. Gino, thank you for being with us.
Morning.
Good morning. Thanks for being on the show. It's the third annual Taste of Keego 2.0. It's different than it's been in the past. You have been the host of Taste of Keego, as it's traditionally been at your other business right next door to Gino's at Santia Hall. Over the past few years, it's become more of a restaurant week supporting and celebrating our local businesses with special deals. For you as a business owner, as a restaurant owner in Keego, how has this change been for you over the past few years?
Well, somewhat of a change. I mean, it was always nice to have everybody at the banquet hall. We get to see all the restaurants, and they mostly all participated. It was a nice event for the city itself. Everybody came out to it and enjoyed it, and it was just nice to see everybody. Of course, doing it this way, you see periodically somebody come in, and you get a chance to talk to them, but not like it was at the banquet hall when everybody's all congregated in a couple of rooms enjoying themselves.
And the good thing about this, though, is it does spread that love throughout the week and still across the restaurants around the community. And, of course, you can find more information on all of these deals going on at restaurants across the city of Keego Harbor by following Keego Harbor Parks on Facebook at KH Parks. Gino Santia from Gino's Pizzeria and Restaurant joins us on the program. And, Gino, earlier this week we had a chance to talk to Kirsten Sonneville Douglas from Keego Harbor Parks and Rec about some of the motivation behind this change and ultimately why Taste of Keego, especially during the COVID-19 pandemic, where it couldn't have happened in its traditional way anyway, needed to stick around. And part of that was to support these local businesses, but also to show them thanks for all the support that they give in the community. And I know that's a key element of your restaurant and of your businesses, being heavily involved in the community. Just how much of a cornerstone of your business is that community involvement?
Well, I don't know if I'm a cornerstone, but I've been here a long time, but not as long as I think there's one other restaurant in the area that's, in fact, I know it is. The Harbor Steakhouse has been here longer than I have, but I've been here 54 years, and I've been a a wonderful part of Keego Harbor. I've enjoyed it immensely. I got involved in the political realm a little bit. I'm on the Planning Commission and a few other organizations. And I've always been involved in the city. I love the city. I don't live in the city, but I really love the city. It's a wonderful city. And I think this taste of Keego is kind of like trying to get everybody to come out and appreciate the city like we do. You know, come enjoy the restaurants we have and the facilities we have. And of course, it's a little different now. We don't have the movie theater. We don't have the back seat. So it's become more of a little more selective when you come to Keego Harbor. So, but we try.
But on that note, Gino, you've mentioned as if you've also kind of dove into the political realm as a member of the Planning Commission, and you're heavily involved in the community and as it forges its future ahead. Now, Keego's had a lot of changes in recent years and recent decades, as you've even mentioned. But you know, as you're going forward and your business has persisted and others have persisted throughout these years, how excited are you for the future of this city and you know what the city at the governmental level and also at the community level is doing to march forward in Keego?
Well, I'm very excited about the future for Keego Harbor. We have some development that we're looking at that's hopefully will begin soon. And I think it'll make a big transition for our city. It will be a very, very huge, huge thing, economic growth for everybody in the city. And I'm looking forward to that. And I'm here to be part of it. So I'm looking forward to it. We've worked on it the last few years, and I think it'll come to fruition very soon.
Gino Santia is the owner of Gino's Pizzeria and Restaurant on Cass Lake Road in Keego Harbor. You can't miss it as you drive by Roosevelt Elementary School and near the City Hall complex in the heart of Keego Harbor. Their meal deals for Taste of Keego 2.0 continue through Sunday from 4 p.m. to 8 p.m. during their special dinner menu, including, and we can put this up on the screen in a moment, Calvin, loaded baked mostaccioli for $18.50, a triple combo of chicken parmigiana, lasagna, and fettuccine alfredo for $18.75, and a medium pizza with cheese and two items for $14.75. You can always keep up to date with Gino's and the latest from their menu by following them on Facebook at 1999 Cass LK RD. Gino, as you prepared for Taste of Keego 2.0 and you put together these meals as your special deals for this week, what about these dishes made you want to put them on display as those key items people can seek out during restaurant week?
Well, we tried to figure out what would be the best and certainly most for your money. Come hungry if you're going to choose one of these meals. There's a lot of food there. Along with the meal itself, you get the salad and, of course, our homemade breadsticks. So it's a nice meal, and it's a nice, a simple meal for anybody to choose from. But we have other things on the menu, too, that are reasonably priced also.
Gino, in recent years, there's been some turmoil at the restaurant, but ultimately the community was able to get behind you as you've gotten behind the community for so many years, and your restaurant has come back and better than ever before. What have been some of the changes on the other side of the fire from a few years ago, and how has your business continued to recover and march forward to continue being a staple of Keego Harbor?
Well, it was a tough 6 months for us. It was very difficult. We tried to help out the employees as much as we could during that period of time. Fortunately, we had the carryout, and that kind of carried us through a little bit, and the fact that I had some really good insurance. The fire damage, it wasn't the damage from the fire. The fire was actually outside the building. The damage was in the smoke. It completely engulfed our whole restaurant, so everything had to be taken out and redone. And we had Belfour do the work, and they did a wonderful job, a beautiful job. Everything turned out really nice, fresh and new. And people were anxiously waiting for us to reopen because it was like mass chaos for several months here after we opened up. But we got through it. We managed it. And it's been wonderful, wonderful for us.
There's some amazing community support behind Gino's.
Yes, it was, very much.
And it really just goes to parallel exactly what you and what your business have done in our community over these many years. You can join Gino at Gino's Pizzeria and Restaurant all throughout Keego Harbor Restaurant Week for special deals, and of course all throughout the year by following them on Facebook at 1999-CASS-LKRD. And also keep up to date on all the restaurants participating in Restaurant Week or Taste of Keego 2.0, Facebook at KH Parks. Gino, anything else that we should know about your restaurant at this time, or other special meals, or maybe some new dishes that maybe people haven't tried yet at Gino's?
Well, we'll have some specials for Valentine's Day coming up, and we have some other special events we do during the year. We have a charity golf outing. We do our annual classic car show in August, and that's always fun. And we usually have a bus trip to the Tiger game, or we try to keep things flowing through here. Everybody has some fun, good times. So.
Great food and good times always at Gino's Pizzeria and Restaurant in Keego Harbor. Gino, thank you so much for your time this morning.
Thank you, Tyler.
Appreciate it. Facebook at KH Parks. For more information on Taste of Keego 2.0, you can find listings of restaurants and their special deals, and keep up to date as others may perhaps join in throughout this week. You can also get more information on our Civic Center TV website at civiccentertv.com. We recently talked to Kirsten Sonneville Douglas about Restaurant Week and other ways you can get involved with Keego Harbor Parks and Rec. Facebook at KH Parks. We'll take a break on the Splash Live. More stories from across town and interesting things to keep up to date on, plus some fun events happening over this weekend that will support our kids in our local schools. We're live, local, and social on the Splash Live, and we'll be right back.
We'll be right back with the Splash Live. Bringing you stories and memories from Sylvan Lake, Civic Center TV, and 89.3 Lakes FM.
One in four Michigan homes has high levels of radon, a naturally occurring radioactive gas known to cause lung cancer. It doesn't matter where you live or what type of home you have. You won't even know it's there unless you test. So don't wait. Testing is cheap and easy. And if there's a problem, it's simple to fix. Visit michigan.gov/radon to learn more.
We took action. Will you?
I don't know why you're so sad. You've got a roof over your head.
You gotta stop with that depressing stuff.
That's what white people think.
You all right?
It just feels like it's coming from everywhere.
Do you want to talk about it?
You can talk to me if you're feeling sad.
Whenever you need to talk, I'm here, okay?
When you have a gambling problem, you have a money problem. Don't let your gambling cause you financial hardship. If you or someone you love is struggling with gambling, we can help. Get free confidential counseling and win your life back. Learn more at michigan.gov/problemgambling.
Missed one of our live broadcasts or one of your local municipal meetings? Check it out online at civiccentertv.com. Every meeting, show, and interview on demand. Thank you for watching and listening to Civic Center TV and 89.3 Lakes FM. And now, back to the Splash Live.
Live, local, social. It's the Splash Live every day on Civic Center TV and 89.3 Lakes FM. Join us Monday through Friday for the latest information from across our four communities. And always keep up to date with us live and on demand on civiccentertv.com. That's also where you'll find links to all of our social media so you can follow us all across the web each and every day and join us live and on demand. Really fun night is on its way this week, Friday. It's West Bloomfield Education Foundation's Casino Night at Glen Oaks Golf Club in Farmington Hills. The tickets are still on sale at this time for Casino Night, and you can get them as we speak. Here's a couple ways you can get with the West Bloomfield Education Foundation in order to get these tickets. WBEF. casinonight.org is their website. And they'll find information not only on casino night and the special ticket levels. There are different. There's the basic level for $45 that gets you a ticket into the event and access to the food and the games and all the fun. Then there's other upper levels you can also join in on for even more of a greater donation and some other special goodies as you go to this event on Friday night. It's going to kick off at 7 o'clock at Glen Oaks Golf Club in Farmington Hills. Runs to about 11 o'clock with casino games, auctions, appetizers, dancing and music, and so much more. There's a QR code on your screen from this flyer right now as we speak, civiccentertv.com, which will give you even more information on this event. It is a ton of fun every single year. People really enjoy going out to this, and it all goes toward supporting kids in our schools and even our educators and improving the educational enrichment in the school district here in West Bloomfield. And that's on display already. Some recent donations making an impact in classrooms at Roosevelt Elementary School, the West Bloomfield School District posting earlier on this week. Roosevelt Elementary School fourth grade students recently got to start enjoying their new social-emotional tools, which were donated to the school as a courtesy grant from the West Bloomfield Educational Foundation. This is available for students when they feel like maybe they're struggling, they're a little bit stressed, they're feeling like they're experiencing some big emotions and they need to manage that, or take a step back, take a breather, have some fun, get their mind off of the stress of the school day, and this becomes a big help in their social emotional learning in the classroom. Supplies were purchased from funds that were in part generated from their annual casino night fundraiser. All the more reason to get out to Glen Oaks Golf Club in Farmington Hills on Friday night for their casino night event. Again, 7 o'clock to 11 o'clock is when that is happening. You can find more information on WBEF.org or follow them on Facebook at West Bloomfield Ed Foundation, West Bloomfield ED Foundation on Facebook. We're still celebrating 50 years of the Greater West Bloomfield Historical Society and its incredible service to our local community, preserving our local history and spreading that history out to our community, keeping us informed about where we've come and bringing future generations information about where we're at right now. We're making history today. We had a really fun opportunity to be with them last weekend at Orchard Lake School's campus at St. Mary's, and they had a really fun event. We have that event recorded in full, and it is going to premiere later on this week. We will have information for you on that on civiccentertv.com. Expect that premiere on Thursday afternoon and in the evening on Civic Center TV and 89.3 Lakes FM. We have that completed and ready. We're getting everything technically ready to put that into broadcast, and we'll have that also available for you on our YouTube page at Civic Center TV. While you're over there, hit the subscribe button, hit the bell icon, and you'll always get notifications when we go live and when we post new videos, including their 50th annual anniversary event and their annual meeting. Really cool information about how big of progress they have made over the past year in 2023, their goals for this year, and recognizing their amazing board members who do such great volunteer work preserving our local history. You can get involved as well by visiting them at gwbhs.org, and that's also a place you can find their Facebook link, Facebook at GWBHS. We'll take a break on the Splash Live. On the other side, learning with animals with Lauren Azuri, West Bloomfield Parks naturalist. She'll join us to talk about a recent encounter at the West Bloomfield Town Hall complex with some deer, plus how your kids can learn from special critters in the nature room at the Recreation Activity Center. Live, local, social, it's the Splash Live. More up next on Civic Center TV and 89.3 Lakes FM.
We'll be right back with the Splash Live. Missed one of our live broadcasts or one of your local municipal meetings? Check it out online at civiccentertv.com. Every meeting, show, and interview on demand. Thank you for watching and listening to Civic Center TV and 89.3 Lakes FM.
Ronnie started doing prescription pills at the age of 15. And by 19, he died. If your child is struggling with drug use, try not to be too proud to reach out for help. Don't be worried about what the neighbor will think or your family. Just get your child the help they need. Sometimes it's the hard road to take, but the hard road is nothing compared to living with the fact that your child is no longer with you.
There's hope and help at drugfree.org.
you stories and memories from Orchard Lake, Civic Center TV, and 89.3 Lakes FM. And now, back to the Splash, live.
Live, local, social, it's the Splash Live, all throughout your work week on Civic Center TV and 89.3 Lakes FM. I'm your host, Tyler Kieft, and thank you for joining us. Welcome back to the program. It's always a great time of the year to learn through nature, and there's always great opportunities to do that over at West Bloomfield Parks in the Recreation Activity Center. They got their nature room, their outdoor natural play area, and classes all throughout the year for the entire family. They get you interacting, learning about nature, and getting your questions answered by experts like the Parks Naturalists over at West Bloomfield Parks. Joining us to talk about a fun upcoming event next week in West Bloomfield and some special encounters recently at the Recreation Activity Center is Lauren Azuri, Parks Naturalist Supervisor with West Bloomfield Parks. Lauren, thank you for being with us.
Hi, Tyler. Thanks for having me.
Yeah, glad to have you on. You got an exciting show coming up, an opportunity for some live animal feeding, photo opportunities, and of course, a lot of learning opportunities with some of the animals in the nature room at West Bloomfield Parks' Recreation Activity Center. Tell us about this upcoming show, Cold-Blooded Critters, live animal show happening in February.
Yeah, so we have lots of live animals, as you can see behind me, that live inside the nature room that we call our animal ambassadors, and they help us teach the public about our native wildlife. But we often like to invite contractors, guest teachers that might have different animals than we have to teach our community about those animals as well. So that's what this live animal cold-blooded critters program is about. It's on February 10th, and we're inviting Nature Discovery, who is a local organization that houses live animals for education, and they are wildlife biologists. They're bringing all native, which means they're from around here, but different than the ones we have. And cold-blooded means it's going to be mostly reptiles and amphibians, so those scaly and slimy creatures. So the ones that you might not see outside in the wintertime, but can see inside the nature room at this time of year. So obviously we love outdoor adventures, but we also like to offer fun learning opportunities inside as well. And our live animal shows are a great way to do that.
And how do those live animal shows, from the standpoint of an educator on your side and with your team, help to bring that nature education to our community? And then from the other side, what do you often see that parents, and especially the kids that are engaging in these programs, ultimately get out of attending a show like this?
Yeah, I think that being able to touch an animal is sometimes a scary thing for kids. Like we never force that on them, of course, but it is a unique opportunity. So if a kid is deciding that that's what they're comfortable doing, it's a great way to engage with nature safely. So obviously we wouldn't be encouraging anyone to do this with wild animals outside, but the jobs of these animals, much like our nature staff here, is to educate. And so being able to have those close encounters helps kids to appreciate nature more. So the more that you can interact with nature, the more you can learn about it, the more you appreciate it, then in the long run, the more you want to protect it. So we're trying to really encourage and create future stewards of our earth. We want all the kids and adult with their adults as well to experience these hands-on animals in a safe setting where they feel comfortable and they can learn. And then hopefully that helps them to be excited about nature in future endeavors and help the earth.
Cold-Blooded Critters Live Animal Show will be happening February 10th, 10 a.m. until 11:30 a.m. in the Nature Room at the Recreation Activity Center on Walnut Lake Road in West Bloomfield. You can learn more information, including how to register for the event on wbparks.org, and find even more information about upcoming programs and special events from West Bloomfield Parks on Facebook at WB Parks, where we're broadcasting today. And then on a wide-ranging scale, Lauren, these classes that you're putting on, some involve the live animals, others are just getting these kids into the nature rooms, showing them some examples of different phenomena they'll see outdoors in their local community. How big of a benefit is it to have this nature room in our community and these opportunities for our kids? And what are some of the focuses from your team on getting this education out to the community and keeping it fresh year in and year out?
Yeah, so we do see a lot of repeat families, which we love. Like, that's really important to continue to grow that. I love when I'm at a big event and I see a family who's a parent comes up to me and they have a kid that's taller than me now, but I taught them and inspired them from when they were short, very short, you know, much younger. And so having those memories in our community are really important. It's amazing that these kids remember these things, but they are so unique experiences that we're able to provide. They might not feel comfortable in the, within their family unit to do so. Like maybe they don't, their parents aren't comfortable going on a trail, but they learn that from coming to our programs, and then they can continue to grow that in their homes and then continue to grow that maybe even in their own backyards. So we definitely love our repeat visitors who like to continue to learn as they grow up here in our community. But we're always hoping to invite new people to the nature room or to our trails. The more that we can learn about our climate and our earth, the more we can do to help. And so we're not just inspiring kids. While we'll often they're a fun group to have here, I love most often, and I know my staff does too, when an adult comes to a program with the intention of entertaining their kid, but they leave and say, wow, I learned so much more than I ever thought I would, even as the adult, not as my child. So we like to educate all ages. You're never too old or too young to learn something new. West Bloomfield Parks is also really big on professional development for our staff internally. So we always love to learn new things. Technology is always changing. Research is always changing about what's happening outside and with our wildlife and our flora and fauna. So we like to learn alongside with people too. And we like to take what we learn and teach our community. So it is nice to be able to reach a broad range, and we love connecting with repeat visitors as well as with new people in the community.
Indoors, outdoors, and all throughout the community, learning opportunities and chances to get outside into nature all throughout the year, including this winter, are available on wbparks.org. Their winter guide has long since been released. Program registration is wide open for the coming weeks and months with West Bloomfield Parks. You can also learn more information and get updates on their Facebook page at WB Parks. Joining us on the Splash Live is West Bloomfield Parks Naturalist Supervisor Lauren Azuri. We had a really cool story that we showed earlier on this week. Recently, West Bloomfield Parks posting a picture on their Facebook page of an unusual interaction at the Recreation Activity Center. It's not uncommon to see deer roaming around at West Bloomfield Town Hall. Heck, I see it all throughout the year. But this is unique because for those that are listening on the radio or later on, there's a deer that's right by a light post that's staring directly at the camera. There's a couple other deer in the background that are kind of almost posing for this picture. And so that kind of sparked in my mind having this conversation with you about interacting with wildlife throughout the year. And they're very docile creatures. They're coming up often close to us, especially these deer at West Bloomfield Town Hall. But there are right ways and there are wrong ways, even well-intentioned, to interact with nature in the winter, especially with our deer.
Correct. So this is actually at our bird feeding station that we have at the Recreation Activity Center. And I think that obviously we all in West Bloomfield Township or any community surrounding us know that we have a high population of deer here, and they are really fun to watch. But the DNR does have a ban on bait feeding or ground feeding deer. So we do not encourage deer to come to our feeding station by putting large amounts of food on the ground for them. It's really a safety and health hazard for them. So what you don't want deer communally feeding in one area where they're sharing like saliva and those kinds of things and can spread disease. It has happened before. Chronic wasting disease was the reason this ban was put into place. So they're trying to prevent that. In our woods, luckily in West Bloomfield, we have a lot of woodland and wetland areas, a lot of natural areas. And so deer actually change what they eat in the winter. So they do eat a lot of green and things that are green and growing in the spring, but as winter is out and about and they're exploring, they tend to do what's called browsing. So they'll chew on the inner bark of twigs and buds. So basically browsing is eating sticks and twigs. And so they're able to find sustenance and food in this winter, but definitely encouraging others to put up a bird feeding station if you do it properly. So we love having our bird feeding station here. It's another great opportunity to engage with nature. I know in these winter months, you might be a little hesitant to go outside, especially with the temperatures we've been having. So it's a great way to engage with and view wildlife from inside if you choose to do so. So having a bird feeding station, making sure that the feed is high off the ground so the deer can't reach it, making sure that you're not putting big chunks on the ground so the deer don't communally feed there. All those things keep our deer safe, but also help us to view amazing birds as well. But yes, that funny deer was a great capture by our social media person. The tongue out was perfect and a fun way to engage with nature for sure. We also keep our bird feeding station close to our windows so that it keeps the birds safe. They're less likely to have window strikes if it's close up. And so, yeah, there's a lot of great ways to engage with nature, and having a bird feeding station is a great way to do that.
We have a great resource right next door to us at West Bloomfield Parks, the Recreation Activity Center, and their Parks Naturalist team, your Parks Naturalist team, always a great resource all throughout the year, posting advice on social media, including on their Facebook page at WB Parks, videos, and of course, all the classes and learning opportunities in the nature room, in the outdoor natural play area, and all throughout our trails across the greater West Bloomfield community. Lauren, if people want to learn more or they want to explore some other nature information in our community, what's the best way they can get in contact with your team?
Oh, yeah, for sure. Our website has a wealth of information. We have our green page. We have our events page. We even have a page that talks about snowshoeing. So wbparks.org is a simple way to do that. Lots of dates and times if you're looking to register. But we also do keep up with our Instagram as well. So our social media marketing team and the naturalist team work closely together. So we post fun facts, green tips and advice. So our Instagram, wbparks, is also a great way to see what's going on here as well.
Facebook.com/WB Parks. You can find them on Instagram. Also, WB Parks, Twitter, WB_Parks. And all these links and more information available on their website, including registering for their upcoming Cold-Blooded Critters live animal show on February 10th. Available on WBParks.org. Lauren, thank you so much for being with us.
Thanks, Tyler.
More information, as always, wbparks.org. To sign up and register for these events, some require registration, and others, such as their upcoming Nature Room open hours, are free, and you do not have to register in order to attend. You can also keep up to date with all their events and find pictures from everything that they're doing across our community. Facebook at wbparks. We're live, local, and social, and we'll continue on with our program after this break. Stay with us. The Splash Live will be right back.
We'll be right back with The Splash Live. Find local municipal meetings at our program schedule on CivicCenterTV.com. Find when your meetings air live or when they're replaying on our Civic Center TV live stream. Find it all at CivicCenterTV.com and click schedule at the top of the screen. Take a break and tune in to The Splash Live on Civic Center TV and 89.3 Lakes FM. Join Tyler Keith as he goes through headlines and events, updating you on the day-to-day happenings in Oakland County. Catch us live weekdays 8:30 a.m. to 12:30 p.m. Watch us on demand at CivicCenterTV.com. Or watch us on TV at Comcast Channel 15 or AT&T at Channel 99. Bringing you stories and memories from Orchard Lake, Civic Center TV, and 89.3 Lakes FM. And now, back to The Splash, live.
Live, local, social, it's The Splash Live on Civic Center TV and 89.3 Lakes FM. I'm your host, Tyler Kieft, and thank you for joining us today and each and every day. All across our network, you can find us on demand on CivicCenterTV.com, as well as links to all of our social media to keep up to date with us all throughout your week. Special opportunity is coming up for artists and crafters, not only in Keego Harbor, but throughout the Lakes area and the greater West Bloomfield area, with Art Sale, a local art collective that began just a few years ago and now has continued to sponsor shows and bring in new artists and help them hone in on their craft and get into shows and sell their art all throughout our community. They have an upcoming show all the way out in April, April 21st, at the Oakland County Farmers Market, but they're seeking artists and crafters to join them for that show as we speak. The applications are currently open, and you can find more information on their Facebook page, including an application link at facebook.com/groups/artsale. Not only is this for artists and crafters, but also just for art enthusiasts across our community as well. This group open to anybody all across the Lakes area. Again, facebook.com/groups/artsale, like the sale of a sailboat. Nominations are open for the Michigan Week Community Awards. If you know a great volunteer in our community that deserves to be recognized for their service in our schools, out and about in our community groups, or doing something special for our community out of the goodness of their own heart. Nominations are now available and open at michiganweek.org. Those are open now through February 16th at 11:59 p.m. So time is starting to run out, but still a couple weeks left to get those nominations in and potentially see these great people being awarded on Friday, May 10th at 7 a.m. at Temple Israel and on our special broadcast of the Michigan Week Community Awards. You can also keep up to date with them on Facebook at GWBMW, otherwise the acronym for Greater West Bloomfield Michigan Week. Live, local, social, each and every day throughout the week, it is The Splash Live. We thank you for joining us to keep up to date on the latest news and information across our community. Stay with us. The Splash Live will continue very soon.